We've got Charlie Clark, first net, 2024, really looking his back foot, getting that left foot in line with the ball and hitting that ball back up the pitch and towards mid-off. That ball coming straight back up the pitch. Good. You work hard with that back foot. That's what I want to see at all the lines. See how feel how close that was to your body, Charlie. That was perfect. That's how it's got to feel when you're punching as well. Good, well played. Bring it on. Hit straight and square later. Good, well played, Charlie, brilliant. Right behind you. Good shot, great shot. Get that back foot across. Watch that ball. Oh, sorry, mate.
Thought you went like the ball.
Sorry. Nearly got you.
Yeah.
Nearly pinned it. Good, Charlie. Good. Nice and straight. Good back. Good behind the square. You'll get a couple there. One half. Good play. Good one. That might be a single, Charlie. Quick single. Look how soft hands those were. If you get across into line with it, Charlie, you'll know what to run and what to lead from your head position. Okay, that one you weren't sure, weren't you? And no. Your gloves.
Yeah, I'm tipping my fingers a couple.
Yeah, and so you've got to try and really stay in line, and then you'll know by staying in line with its width or not to be able to cut or pull that one, because you won't fight across, you are cut it or do I play it straight. Okay, look with that footwork, real positive footwork. Move those two behind you, Charlie, just in case. Step on. Good. Pull the foot across. Get in behind that line. Thank you. one before, Charlie, was when I say shape it, I mean keep the elbow high, because that one you can punch on the back foot. The more shots you hit with a straighter bat, the safer it's going to be. When we go to cross bat, there's a lot more danger involved in the shot, yeah? So you can wait for the width, it wasn't quite wide enough. Top of, okay, what can we get on top of with this back foot punch? Realistically,
like below my chest ish.
I'd say waist, I think belly button, anything below your belly button. Just show me a backward defensive and just have a look at the height of the middle of the bat. See where the middle of the bat is? Yeah, you're struggling to get the bat any higher than that, aren't you? So that's belly button and waist height. Once it gets bigger than that, you've got to think probably here, I've got to drop it and run.
Yeah.
Don't look to be too creative with it, yeah? You try and get the middle of the bat. It's hard to get the middle of the bat any higher off the back foot. You can physically get your hands high, okay? In between, weren't we?
Yeah, I should have just committed.
Yeah. Whatever you do, Charlie, commit.
Yeah.
You know, if you get it wrong, don't go through half-hearted. If you think, you know, you've gone there, you're going to cut it, bloody cut it like you would cut it. It's too tight to you. That's fine, but at least you feel you've gone wholehearted. When you get that, oh, and you don't do anything, and the feather just comes through to the keeper, whereas if you actually flash at it, and you end up nicking it, it can fly.
Yeah.
And the chance of being caught are much more minimal, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So don't pull out halfway, just go through with it. Shot. Good one. Lovely shot. Last one. Right, left arm over or around now. I'm going to change the angle. What changes here, do you think?
A lot more on my leg.
A lot more goodness. Yeah. Okay, so slightly different. So again, you're getting into line. Don't try and get inside the line. I'm trying to get inside. You can get it in that awkward area. Stay in line with it. Still looks a bit straight.
Yeah.
Okay. Likely, if it's left arm over or round, Charlie, you had a lot more that hits straight down the ground. Because the natural angle of the ball is coming into it, so it's much harder to hit squarer.
Yeah.
The ball's going that way, and you hitting that way, the two of them don't meet. So often, more often than not, you get a little bit straight off round, I think, yeah? Or to the left arm.